Hello, what's good? We're tuned in with my boy Private Zero. What's good, bro? What are you telling him?
Everything's good right now, man. Bless.
Bless, yeah. Well, where are you coming from?
West. Just had a session.
Okay, how did the session go?
Good. Done my thing.
What? How many tracks do you record? Are you the type of guy that records multiple tracks, or are you more like one track per session, or how does it get down with you in the studio?
It depends on the amount of time I have. Sometimes I can fit in two, but normally it's one, because I would have a short session, but I have a lot of sessions in a week, so it's not really too
bad. How many sessions be every day or every 2 days?
Sometimes it's every day, sometimes it's like five times a week. Sometimes I just get two a week, but most weeks it's a lot of sessions, so
yeah,
I'm busy, yeah.
Okay. It's been a very good year for you so far, though. Obviously, you dropped Somebody Else, then More. You had two Mixtape Madness freestyles in there.
Yeah.
So, like, how is it adjusting to this new fame? How has it been so far?
You know what it is? I don't think I've lived every bit of it. So, I think everything that's come forward now, a bit of the fame, I don't think it's been too bad. Just certain things that are a little bit irritating, but it is what it is. It's life. It's expected, so yeah.
It's a massive change, though, isn't it? Just from being a regular guy doing this, massive. And now you're Private Zero. With all this like attention coming through, I know you're getting the ladies, isn't it?
A little bit. But
we spoke earlier, you're taken, aren't you?
Yeah, man.
What would you consider? Be honest with me, yeah? Be honest. It's just me, you, and the listener, yeah?
Yeah.
We ain't got to tell. Don't worry. We ain't going to tell nobody, yeah?
Yeah.
Would you consider yourself a loyal guy? Or when there's a sweet one in your studio sessions or videos, you're going to move to? Be honest, bro. It's cool.
Nah, I'm not really on that.
Oh, you're not on that, yeah?
To be fair, I wouldn't really move into girls before anyway.
Okay.
I did stop doing that a while back.
Oh, yeah.
Just because the females sometimes are just not everything that you think they are.
They come with too much drama as well.
Too much, yeah.
For anyone that doesn't know you, how would your friends and family describe you?
A lot of the times I'm a bit of a joker.
A joker, yeah.
Yeah, I like to run jokes in serious moments.
You
sometimes.
Was definitely that guy in school, innit?
100%.
Throwing pencils, getting on the teacher's nerves.
100%. Kicked out of a lot of classes.
But I saw on your TikTok that you are juggling like a night shift and this music thing as well. So that tells me that you're hardworking. Like, how is it balancing both of them?
It was a struggle. Like, see, when you work night shift, it's like you have no life.
Oh, yeah.
You get home and sleep and wake up, you got to go straight back.
Oh, swear.
You have no life.
Do you know what? That messes with your sleep schedule as well.
It does. I was sleeping from around like 11 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Okay.
Get up, leave for 8 o'clock.
So
whole life.
When did it kick in that you wanted to do music?
Maybe like I always wanted to do it, but never. I was never too serious. I got serious maybe like 4 weeks into the warehouse. I was like, I can't be doing this. I can't.
Yeah. So if it wasn't for music, do you have any skills outside of it? Maybe kicking ball, maybe sports or anything like
that. I can kick ball.
You can kick ball. Yeah. What position are you playing?
I stopped at attacking midfield. I played everywhere. But I think my longest serving position would probably be right wing.
Right wing. What are you, quick, skills, dribbles?
Quick still. I'm quick.
All right, cool. We're going to get more into the music thing right after this one. I'm going to spin Somebody Else. Do you want to introduce it to the people?
This is my first ever single. This is my favorite. And I hope you enjoy it. If you're heartbroken, this will heal you still.
Let's get into it. Just played Private Zero's debut single, Somebody Else. Boy, big tune, I can't lie.
It is though, it's a song.
Currently sitting on 1.4 million views on YouTube.
Yeah.
9 million streams. When you first recorded that song in the studio and you went home and you listened to it, like, did you think it would blow up this much?
Not this much, nah.
Not this much?
I was thinking maybe like a cheeky 100K on YouTube.
100K
on YouTube? That was me being excited. So this is, it's crazy.
I think, do you know what helped? TikTok helped a lot.
Yeah.
When you dropped it, was the marketing strategy called, what we're going to do is we're going to put it on TikTok and we're going to make a lot of people dance to it? Or was it more authentic? You kind of put it there and then people just...
It was more just my manager and my cousin said, cool, just take a bunch of snaps and videos of you in the studio, put the song over it and post it on TikTok, just see what happens. That was it.
What was the moment where it snapped and you thought, rah, hold on a second, this might go off? Is it a certain tastemaker or influencer reposted it, or?
I think I did. I had a comment from Unknown T.
Oh, is it?
And I screenshotted it and posted it, and then he popped up to it. So he messaged me, and he was sending me voice notes saying like you're talented, and I was like, rah, this is crazy.
That must have been an unreal. From
it
there,
was unreal. Yeah.
Bare motivated, innit?
Yeah.
Cool. So let's talk about more a little bit. What's your creative process behind more?
This one's a bit boring, to be fair. I was going to a bunch of sessions after I recorded someone else. I started going to a lot more sessions. And one day I just went back to my cousin's house and he found this beat. And then I was like, yeah, like, this is something.
Yeah.
So I just started writing. And then I wrote half. And then when I got my session, I wrote the other half. And then just laid it down.
So do you prefer to write at home or do you, like, freestyle in a studio and get a vibe from there?
A bit of both, to be fair. When I'm at home, if I find a beat that requires me to write something, I'll write something at that time. Like, because sometimes my creativity will just not be there. So I'll save the beat. But if it's there, I'll just shut myself away from everyone and just get into my phone.
Do you want people to take from your music? That you're a lover boy, that women are trash, don't trust women? Like, what is it?
Well, nah, to be fair, for someone else, it is to say, like, don't put all your energy into females. Yeah. Be lit on your own. Learn how to be lit on your own. So then when days come where there's no females, you know what you're doing. You're good. You don't need people.
Yeah.
Like, I think guys don't realize how much they let females mash up their mental health.
Yeah.
Like, it's bad.
You sound like you've been through it yourself.
Yeah, when I was young in school, yeah. Mm. But this song more, it wasn't really, there's not really a real heartbreak story behind it. I just think that I really liked the beat and then just laid whatever.
Okay.
And then when I've heard the song back, I've said, yeah, this is a story. I'm gonna have to make a movie for this.
Yeah.
Because even though I haven't gone through it, I've created something where people that have gone through it can go and relate to it.
Okay.
And they can go and feel better because they're gonna know that there's a lot of other people in the comments that are saying, yeah, I've been through this as well, and they'll feel better about it. Because it's a normal thing. Heartbreaks, it's normal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So right now the scene is that congested and filled with so much young talent.
So much.
How do you feel that you stand out from the rest of them?
I don't really see myself as standing out yet, to be fair. Yeah. A lot of people say it, but I don't really feel it. But I think I stand out in a way as in that, like, I don't think people make music the way I do. Like, I feel like I do it a little bit different.
Mm.
But at the end of the day, I don't really compare myself to a lot of people. I don't like to do that.
Because in your own lane, yeah?
Yeah. Just stay in your own lane, because reality is, everything is kind of like, it's like boxing. You're really fighting yourself.
Yeah.
If you look at it properly. Because if you look at someone else as a target, then that's, after you pass that, where do you go?
Exactly.
But if you're onto yourself,
you're always trying to
elevate. You're always with yourself. So every time you elevate, you're going to beef yourself again, and then you're going to elevate again and again and again. If you're looking at someone else, you're just trying to top them, and then that's just... Yeah.
For a young guy, you're proper wise, you know. I'm sure the listener right now is going to get some gems from you.
Hopefully.
But let's get right into Private Zero's second single, This One's More. I got a few more questions just about you and your music and the future. So what, who's rating in the scene right now?
Clavish,
yeah?
100%,
I think he's next up still. Definitely.
I've been listening to Clavish from like a year now.
Yeah.
And since I started coming studio and chilling with a lot of people, I've been putting on Clavish saying, listen to this.
Yeah.
And now he's popped off. And it's
Defo.
Like, his last tune he dropped, he was 9 on trending the other day.
Yeah.
So, like, it's good to see, like, and then there's girls just posting that line about the dinger, and that it makes me laugh because you didn't want to take him in before, but I'll let it happen because this is what he deserves. You know what I'm trying to say?
Definitely deserves it still.
Yeah.
If you could make a tune with one rapper, who would it be?
Santan.
Santan Dave,
Yeah.
That would be a fire track.
He
still
has been, like, probably my favorite rapper in the UK since.
You and Santan Funky Dave Friday. On a track, I'd start crying, fam, because I know your heartbreak lyrics and his lyricism, fam.
Trust me. But it's a lot more than heartbreak that goes down in the studio. It's just the first two singles.
First two singles. What you got coming up next for them?
Coming up next, I'm gonna make people dance.
You're gonna make people dance.
Alright,
cool. Say no more. Yeah. Private Zero, thank you so much for joining me in the studio today.
It's a pleasure, man.
You got anything left to say to the people?
Anything left to say? Enjoy the music, man. Stay posted. you're gonna want tea.